Hi everyone, I'm Jeff Jolie, I'm product manager in our infrastructure team based in Barcelona. And today I'd like to talk to you about Kubernetes and EKS and how at New Relic we provide a deep monitoring for this. So first, I'd like to go quickly over how we came to Kubernetes. Not so long ago, the application were still running on physical servers and we migrated them to VMs. So that was just the beginning of their journey. In 2013, Docker introduced the containers, and very quickly they took off and we started to see people adopting them because they provided a lightweight option to run your workloads and easily package them. But soon after, people realized that the containers were sprawling, we had a number of containers in your environment, and it was difficult to manage them as well, keeping track of them and deciding on which instances you were going to run them. So about 2014, we started to see new options appear, such as Docker Swarm appeared. And then in 2015, Google introduced Kubernetes as a way to orchestrate your containers based on a tool that they had been using internally for many years. So in Amazon, as soon as Google released the Kubernetes, you could run it on top of EC2 instances, and this provided a way to manage your workload. It took up very quickly because you didn't have to manage the instances individually, and your application people were able to deploy their own application without having to talk to the infrastructure guys. They were able to deploy without having to fill up a request, so it was making their life much easier and faster as well. On the other side, deploying a Kubernetes cluster is something hard, and we often hear from our customers that they struggle in their adoption to deploy the cluster, manage it, monitor it. So last year at reInvent, just 1 year ago, Amazon introduced EKS, Elastic Kubernetes Services, a managed option for Kubernetes, giving you a way to deploy Kubernetes very quickly and also provide a lightweight management, so reduce the overhead of managing your Kubernetes cluster. And that's available now in the Europe and USA regions. And at New Relic, we see a massive adoption of Kubernetes in general and of EKS in particular inside Amazon. We started our monitoring for Kubernetes over the summer, and we're already monitoring thousands of nodes for our customers. So why are people adopting Kubernetes? There's a few important things that it provides. First, it helps the companies move faster. So where I mentioned briefly that before you had to fill in a service request, wait for a VM to be provisioned, now you can directly request via Kubernetes to get your instances provisioned in a cluster and get your app up and running in a few minutes. So it's very much quicker and faster to deploy your own application. The developers are independent and they don't need to get input from other teams in order to roll out their new applications. Second, it's cost efficient. So as you can pack more workloads onto your servers, you can reduce the amount of the cost of your infrastructure. You can run more applications into a lower set of servers. It's also lowering the overhead of managing your environment. You have options such as EKS where you don't need a dedicated team to manage it. And finally, it's portable, so you can develop and package your application into your on-premise environment, on your laptop, and you can then deploy them in the cloud without having to change a single line of code, without having to repackage your application. So it provides people a very easy and faster way to deploy their own application, but also to move them from on-premise to the cloud, from EC2 to EKS, so giving them a lot of options. As people adopt Kubernetes, they need to rethink the way they are doing their monitoring. You have new layers of abstraction, such as the Kubernetes clusters, the nodes, the pods and deployments, but also the same objects that you were looking at before, such as your application, your containers, are still present. So you will want to be able to reply to questions such as, is my Kubernetes cluster and my nodes healthy? Am I able to deploy new application inside of my cluster? Do I have enough resources to take on new workloads? And as well, are my application running on top of my infrastructure healthy? Is the issue that I'm looking at a problem with my infrastructure, with Amazon, or is it with my application? And these issues are important in the way that you want to have a single view on all of your context. You will also ultimately want to take a look at the end user experience and see if the performances on a browser or an application on your mobile are as efficient as you're expecting. So this is why at Neuralink we've developed a tight integration with Kubernetes running on top of AWS. And it provides several advantages. And rather than go through this list, I will show you a brief demo of all these points and walk you through our Kubernetes monitoring integration, starting with the install. And to do that, I'm going to move to the command line. Wait. Oh. Here. Can you see that? Right. Great. So in order to deploy our monitoring integration, you just need to go through three steps. All the commands that I'm going to type are coming straight from our documentation, from our online documentation. So this is just a copy and paste. This is going to download the manifest file, so a native element of configuration for Kubernetes, which describe how are the objects inside of Kubernetes. Our integrations for the monitoring comes as a daemon set. A daemon set is a construct in Kubernetes that ensures that one version of your application is going to run on every single node of your cluster. And when you scale up or when you scale down, you will not have to perform any action to start to monitor the new node. So this is important when you have an elastic cluster. So here I have downloaded my manifest and I will be configuring it. I have already prepared the configuration file here. I just have to change two variables. The first one being the cluster name. So here I name it reinvent 18 demo cluster. And the second is my license key. That's all I need to do to deploy it in my cluster. Once I have done that, using the Kubernetes command, I'm able to create the object. Using this configuration file, Kubernetes calls this manifest, and this will deploy the Neuralink Kubernetes monitoring integration inside of my cluster. So I see here that the object have been created, so I will be able to see that this has just been created. So I see that now it's running, and since 11 seconds, so I just installed it. Now, as soon as I deploy this monitoring integration, I will get a view of the health, the resources, and the performance of my cluster. So I will get this dashboard out of the box that provides me information about my Kubernetes cluster. And because we are a software as a service, you don't have to perform anything else than deploy this manifest file into the cluster to get information. So here I will see information about the resources, how it's being used. I will see the native objects from my Kubernetes environment. I will have information such as my container CPU, the memory, the storage usage, as well as some metrics that are very specific to Kubernetes, such as the container restarts. And these are things that you want to monitor in an environment for Kubernetes. So from there, I'm able to create an alert so that I don't have to watch the dashboard to get alerted in case of the issue, and I can get alerted in case of a problem. And I'm going to create an alert for my incomplete deployments. So when I do a deployment inside Kubernetes, I will declare that I want to have 10 instances of my application, for instance. And it could happen that I'm only able to deploy 7 by lack of resources, for instance, so I want to be alerted on that. So I will create this alert on incomplete deployments. I will be able to restrict it to only alert on the instances that I'm responsible for. So my deployment name here is routing. And based on that, I will select the trigger, which is available pods are less than the desired pods. So as I was mentioning, if you want to have 10 instances and you have less than your 10 instances for more than 5 minutes, I want to get alerted. So here I will create my alert, and it will be created inside of my environment. So here I have just created an alert for my incomplete deployments that has just been configured now. So now, where it becomes very powerful is where you bring the application together with the infrastructure in one single view. Let me take you through a very short scenario where I'm an application developer and I've been assigned a namespace inside Kubernetes where I'm autonomous. I can perform my own deployments, deploy my own application without having to talk to anyone, and I have my own slice of the cluster of the resources that I'm responsible for. And here I have a view of both my application, the response time, the load duration, as well as information about my Kubernetes deployments. So how many pods are available within my deployments. And here, I just deploy a new version of Nginx. I'm going to make that a bit bigger. So I just deploy a new version of Nginx, and I see that it's 0% complete. So I will straight ahead be able to filter this view to see all the containers that composes it and see their status. And I will see that I have three containers. They are all in the waiting status. And the reason is image pool backoff, which generally means that I've made an error in my configuration and the name of the image is incorrect. So here I was very quickly able to determine what was the cause of the problem. So I've shown you that it's easy to install, that you, as a developer, I can get information about both my application and my infrastructure. And I would like now to show you that continuing this scenario where I'm a developer, I'm able to deploy my own application without having to talk to anyone. And I also want to push the automation a bit further and not having to go to New Relic to set up my alert. And I want to set this up proactively and automatically using the API. So here I will when I will develop a new application, I will be able, through the command line and using our New Relic API, to deploy new alerts so that I get alerted if my application has an issue. So here, let me quickly go and to this script that I have prepared to create an alert condition inside of my environment. What this is going to be doing is just calling an API endpoint using the API key that I have retrieved from my New Relic account. And here, I'm going to pass a JSON file that defines the alert. So I name it incomplete deployment 2. And I will watch for the pods that are unavailable for more than 5 minutes. And in this case, I will be able to restrict this to just one of my namespaces. So for instance, I only want to be alerted on my production. I don't want to be woken up at night for issues on my developer environment. So using this quick script, I will be able to create this alert condition in my environment. So I just executed it, and I see it's created. So if I come back to my platform, to the GUI, I will be able to see that I just created this incomplete deployment alert, and I just created this a minute ago. So that concludes the demo. I would like to give you a brief summary of what we have shown now. So what did you see in the demo? First, you saw that it was very easy to deploy the New Relic Kubernetes monitoring. It's only 3 steps. And it's done in a matter of a minute. Then we saw that you have a deep monitoring from your application to the infrastructure stack, crossing through the layers. We've seen that it's AWS native, so I can deploy it on top of EKS or EC2. So I have a variety of platforms that can be monitored. And we saw that it's extensible, so you can use the API to develop and put in place your own alerts without having even to go through the GUI. So that concludes my presentation. Thanks a lot for watching it. I'm very interested to hear about your Kubernetes environments, your journey into deploying it, whether you're in production development. I'm the product manager for Kubernetes development, so all your feedback is interesting to me. Come and talk to me after the demo. Thank you very much.